Seatbelts save thousands of lives every year, so it might surprise you to learn those life-saving belts can contribute to fetal injury when pregnant people are involved in car crashes. Consumer Reports reveals the important safety steps you need to take when driving while pregnant.
Vehicles and restraint systems are designed for average-sized men. That potentially leaves small women, the elderly, and children more vulnerable in a crash. And it's bad for pregnant people.
To address that risk for pregnant people, some companies sell seatbelt adjusters or positioners, devices that attach to the lap portion of a seatbelt and essentially anchor it down between the user's legs, further away from the abdomen. But do they work?
The problem with these seatbelt adjusters is that the government does not set any standards for these devices and they do not regulate them. So experts still believe that the three-point seatbelt is a pregnant person's best bet, and that any modifications to the car's safety restraint system can be problematic.
So even though the seatbelt in your car was not designed specifically to protect pregnant people, it is still your best option for safety if you wear it correctly. First, adjust your seat so that you have as much distance as possible between your belly and the steering wheel. Adjust the steering wheel so that you can comfortably reach it and the pedals. Then put your seatbelt on, adjust the shoulder belt height, and then make sure your lap belt is properly positioned. Don't wear the lap belt over your belly since that could harm your fetus in a crash. Make sure the lap belt is positioned underneath your belly. It should fit snugly across your hips and pelvic bone.
Another reminder, never disable the airbag. If you don't have to be the driver, it's best to sit in the front passenger seat with the seat pushed as far back from the dash as possible. We'll be right back.